just go live. Right, so go live.
Yeah.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the Motorpoint Arena for this NIHL Division 1 North playoff quarterfinal here between the Nottingham Lions and the Billingham Stars. It's a special occasion here. Lions battled hard throughout the season. They have now got themselves a spot in those playoff positions. And it is time for the quarterfinals. I am Dylan Pick, and I'll be taking you through the play-by-play action today. And I'm joined by the ever-so-lovely and the Elite League superstar, fan favourite of the Nottingham Panthers, and the Twitch phenomenon, Lucas Sheldon.
Nice to be here. I think superstar is a bit of a stretch, but I'll take it. Thank you.
Aspiring Rainbow Six Siege professional we have next to us tonight. Yeah, we've managed to rope Luca in to the commentary booth, which is just block 15 of the Motorpoint Arena, as the Stars hit the icing, get a loud roar there from their travelling contingent. The number one seed, league champions, a drop in form at the end of the season, only winning 2 of 9 games, but nonetheless, it was enough to secure the title. 2 points ahead of the chasing Solihull Barons. It was a close league in the end, where top three separated by just 4 points. So we'll get the team sheets just in a sec, but we'll take a few moments for the national anthem. So the national anthem is complete here, and we are just moments away from some hockey action. We'll go through the team sheet for everyone this afternoon for the home side of Nottingham Lions. Number 9, Luke Thomas. Number 10, Michael Bohowski. Number 11, Jack Crowe. Number 13, Josh Heyman. Number 14, Toby Fisher. Number 18, Isaac Ballinger. Number 21, Parson Mervan. Number 25, Owen Davis. Number 29, Dan Martin. Number 59, Deacon Hardy. Number 63, Sam Miller. Number 67, Harry Rushby. Number 74, Luke Birchall. Number 75, Finn Wall. Number 76, Liam Orton Shaw. Number 87, Tyler Summerton. Number 95, Robert Oxley. Number 96, Tristan Grimshaw. And for the visitors of the Billingham Stars, number 5, James Moss. Number 8, Joe Walls. Number 12, Tommy Spraggan. Number 14, James Helens. Number 15, Chris Sykes. Number 18, Joe Dowdle. Number 19, Sean Galloway. Number 19, Verlon Gretans. Number 30, Thomas Brown. Number 32, Michael Elden. Number 33, Mark Turnbull. Number 62, Patrick Grigors. Number 70, Callum Wilkinson. Number 77, Lewis Horn. Number 88, Lucas Dowdle. Number 98, Alex Preston. So I'll pass it to my lovely assistant and the goaltending expert. What are your thoughts on the game today, Ben?
Well, I mean, from a goaltending side of things, I think Billingham's goalie, you know, he's one of them goalies that can very much keep him in the game. I mean, obviously, we're missing Zach, so I guess offensively, we maybe were not as strong as we have been throughout this season, but you know, it really depends on how he plays today, if I'm 100% honest with you.
Yeah, Lions missing a lot of players. Obviously, Kieran Gibbs out with injury, Zach suspended, no Nick Martin either. Short bench for a home game. Billingham, you mentioned the goalie Thomas Brown, best goalie on the league statistically, highest save percentage and the lowest goals against. It's going to be a tough one. You've got Isaac Ballinger starting in there. What are your thoughts on that one?
Isaac is a really good goalie, but I think he struggles sometimes, same as me. We're quite small, aren't we? So he's got to make sure he's moving around quickly. But, you know, if he's done his game, he can keep the Lions in it as well. He's a good little goalie.
Well, first icing of the game there, done by the Lions. Face-off was won by the Stars, chased down the Lions. Clear face-off in the Lions zone to the right of the goal. What are your predictions for the game and score-wise?
Oh, score-wise, we're going to win. I mean, we've got to be confident, aren't we? So, I'll go 5-3 Lions.
Well, Stars win the face-off. Drop back to the blue line now. Down towards the line. Played in front off the pad. Vera Ballinger comes out towards the centre of the blue line. Now to the face-off. Cross-throw again off of the leg there of Orton Shaw. And it'll be cleared out of the line zone. Gained the zone with Tyler Summerton in it. Taken off from there by Spraggan. Back with Summerton, he dumps it and it heads behind Stars Golan. Both sides go for the personnel change. Stars coming through the run zone for the breakout. Moving through Neuschweiz down the left wing. Dumped on net and pushed aside there by Ballinger. Galloway with the boards for the Stars. Batting with him is Oxley and battled on out by Grimshaw. Clearing zone, moving down the left wing for the Lions. Turned over there and dumped in by Grigors. Behind his own net with his Orton Shaw lined. Not got enough of that, and Luke Burton's going to be under pressure in the corner. Now to the left side, cleared out. And the Lions up to breakaway, but Gritans outstrengthening Robert Oxley there, and the Stars back with it once again. Game of the zone, left side. Take the time, dump down towards Moss. Moss held up by Rushby and Orton Shaw have a chance to chase. Up towards the point now, dumped in on net. Through traffic, it's blocked by Gritans. Now back out to the point again for Helens. Now Galloway. Still at the blue line on the left-hand side. Out towards Grigors on the opposite side. Dumped in on net and gloved down by Isaac Ballinger. And we're going to face off in the Lions zone. What do you make of that first big save of the game then for Isaac?
It's a good save. I mean, luckily he could see it all the way in, but I mean, not to take anything away from that. It's still a good save. Well held.
Stars on the face again. Dowdle shoots early, deflects off Parsons' stick and into the glass. Stays in play, however. Back out to the point again. One timer from Walls. He's wide of the net. Back behind the goal. It is with the Stars under pressure. Turnover and Bahowski. Plays out to the opposite corner. That's Porvo from Finn Wall. Turns over again. Just kept in the blue line by Spraggan. Stars doing well to maintain possession. Pushed over by Parson. As one of the Stars forwards is going to be rimmed around to the right-hand side. Kept in towards the corner. It takes a deflection from the Lions. Might be able to clear the zone here. Not just quite kept in the blue line, but Finn Wall's over for the Lions. And Parson, good stick. Can't quite beat Walls though, and the Lions struggling to break out their own zone. Nearly turn over towards Lucas Dowdle at the hash marks. And out it comes, the Lions will eventually get a change, and Walls is with the Stars and rims it around his own net. Poor there, turn over. Could be a chance here for Dan Martin, but can't quite get a hold of it, and the Stars come back with a wave. Again, the zone once again coming on the offensive. One on three, shot coming in early there, but it's wide of the net for the Stars. Changing Stars' line, a quick over the zone for the Lions. Slashing it down, getting a chance to break out from the zone, dumping it, asking for an icing, but it was well over the red line. Stars' bench unhappy with it, but not too much trouble. Elder with it now, gained the blue line, coming down, we're going to have a chance on Ballinger, straight in through, backhand! Just save there by Ballinger, back out to the top of the face-off zone, finally with a shot there. Was Dowd. And I'll come back the other way, is Fisher. Dan Martin threw him on the back to Fisher, shot on! Oh. And takes the deflection off the stick of Brown and into the netting. First real chance for the Lions. But they're struggling to make it out of their own zone there, Luca. defensively we're doing good, but we need to do a bit better in the neutral zone.
Yeah, we need to make sure we keep Insights and Aldi. You know, they're guys that can really change the pace of the game and initiate a breakaway, and they can get a few goals behind them.
Yeah, it's... They're currently on the constant on the back foot. It's kind of what you expect. Playing the stars, if that's going to go all the way down, no icing towards the Lions goal. Picked up by Orton Shaw. Again, not great by Orton Shaw. Tried using the ball, just going to come out to no chance!
Great save.
Just off the side netting there. Real chance for Grittans, and coming back the other way, Luke Burchill for the Lions for neutral zone. Going to be dumped and chased by Grimshaw, but he's going to lose the battle out there to Helens. And the Stars a bit behind their own goal line. It's those chances that the Lions are going to have to take those odd-numbered breakaways over the blue line shot. Didn't catch much of it there from the Stars, and Ballinger's going to have to try and hold it. There's a scramble in front of there. There's Harry Rush being with it, and Ballinger will eventually cover it up. But it's a little bit better from the Lions. They're getting a chance. Moving away through the neutral zone. They're doing well to clear the blue line. But that second, third, and final third, they're struggling a bit. What do you think they need to be doing?
We need to make sure we're not just whacking and hoping. There seems to be a few guys behind the net, especially in the corner. They just seem to hit it out and hope for the best. And we're just giving them back at the blue line. So we need to just focus on.
Yeah, a bit of composure definitely needed. Behind the goal it goes again. Out towards Owen Davis. Oh. Big shove there, pushing down Josh Heyman. Another check, Josh Heyman.
The haymaker.
They're bringing it down with a bit of speed behind the goal. Playing it through to the middle, saved by Ballinger. Straight into his glove, into the middle of his stomach. Because big hit by Josh Heyman to one of the Stars players. And has returned the favour of someone got Luke Birchnell, I think. In the neutral zone, but... Take a hit to make a play. Stars coming back, but again, big save by Ballinger. He's looking locked in tonight.
That's just Josh Heyman for you. He just falls into people.
Goalie knows a goalie. Stars win the face-off on the right-hand side. It's going to be dumped out towards Fisher. And Lions have a chance to move through the neutral zone. Can't quite get the blue line. It's going to turn over. And Chris Sykes with a chance to get moving. He's got past one of the Lions defensemen. Got a chance. He's got a tight angle off an escape there of Davis. And Wilkinson plays it back round towards Sykes behind the Lions' goal. Under the pressure there by Owen Davis. Owen Davis gives an elbow to Sykes. Sykes looks to the referee for assistance, but no call made. Summerton in the corner. He's going to be pinned up and into the boards there by Helens. He returns the favour from Sykes and over the blue line. Wilkinson with it for the Stars. Stars back in their own zone now. Fisher on the forecheck and stuck on with it is Griggs. Dumped on net from range there. Well, Summerton allows Lions to go for a change. Dan Martin with it in the corner of the Stars zone, far side, but that gets turned over as he was outnumbered. 1-4 on the Stars, up to break out the other way, 2-on-3 coming. Dumped down by Wilkinson, Galloway will chase, battle will be one out and losing an edge there. Galloway as he goes hard into the board, the Lions have space to work there. Just ahead and asking for a whistle and still down on the ice is going to be Wilkinson. He lost an edge, big, it looked like he went head first, there was no contact from the Lions player behind him, but he certainly looks hurt, and on comes the physio for the Stars, and that's not good there for the 22-year-old forward. You can see almost Stars above his head there, no pun intended, looking very dazed, but he's up onto his feet now, and it looks to be okay, just a bit of a niggle in his back. Better there from the Lions. Getting the breakout a lot easier, making the passes, looking more comfortable. They're taking your advice, Lucre, it seems.
Yeah, see, that's what I told him before the game, you know, when I was on the bench. Just told him all, gave him some words of wisdom.
That Pam's experience there from.
We'll see how well it goes.
Dumped on net from behind the red line onto the pads of Brown. Lions with it in. The Star Zone breaking out now with a bit of speed. Chance to go 2-on-2, but couldn't get a stick onto all the way. It was Grittans on the floor. There is one of the Lions players. The Lions gained the blue line with Moss. And coming through into the Lions Zone there, the Stars with it. Dumped back behind the corner again, being pinned up by Captain Luke Thomas. There is James Moss. Now Helen's over, turned over towards Luke Thomas, but bouncing foot takes a whack at it and gets it second time round. Oxley's going to have to be quick to it to beat Galloway. Galloway fought about the hit, but it would have been right through the numbers and thinks better of it. Back out towards the blue line again and dumped down behind goal. There's a stick down on the ice and Luke Thomas' space to work with. Backhand round to the near side, but it's turned over towards Helen. Now to the far side, blue line, dumped in and took a deflection, but Ballinger saw it all the way through and off his pad shot low. Luke Thomas behind Vanette in the trapezoid. Rims round as Lions go for a change, being careful not to get too many men, and a heavy touch there from Preston as he comes over. Could have had a chance to catch the Lions sleeping, but Housey is going to tie up the Stars forward and take a deflection of that. The stick in front of the crease, that nearly went into the net. There was chaos there, and Lions get away with one. Out towards the blue line, kept in there by Walls. Down towards the hash marks on the far side. Back towards Walls. Heavy touch behind the goal there by Preston. Run back round towards Luke Thomas, who's felt a lot of this contained zonal pressure of the Stars behind his own net. Comes out in front, and there's going to be a chance and saved there by Ballinger low off of his left leg. Behind the net towards Rushby. Clears out towards Walls. Lions unable to clear Brown's own shot, saved by Ballinger, covered up with 11:45 to play here in the second, and Ballinger has got Lions out of trouble a few times already. Shake up your head, Berlus, you don't look too happy. You want to run us through what happened then, what caused Lions' struggles in their own zone?
It's just the same as what I said a minute ago. We just seem to get panicky, you know. I don't know if it's the nerves of it being the quarterfinals or what, but... Oh, good save. Couple of good saves there. But I think we just get a bit nervous and we're just hitting and hoping for the best and just giving it him straight back. So we end up being pinned in for 2-3 minutes without being able to change. That's not what we need.
Yeah, definitely doesn't look like they're playing much heads-up hockey. There's a chance for Lions to break through on free. Clearing their own zone, moving with speed from the neutral zone, is Dan Martin's shot wide of the net, coming out to the near side. Liam Walshaw picks it, backhand dump, but it takes a deflection. The Stark does come with a bit of speed. Odd man, and indeed they will do. 2-on-1, move down to the Lillard's grip hand, plays off to the far side towards Galloway. Save by Ballinger. Big, and the Lions can come back with way. Not moving with much speed, allowing the start to back check a bit. Rimming it round, dumping, there's going to be a trip down Martin Astro, the blue line, nothing called, and straight over towards Patrick Grigors. Lays off to Moss, moving through, neutralised for the Stars. Gets past Finn Wall, now down to the far side. Wall through the middle, saved by Ballinger. Moss going all the way round, got Helen's waiting at the blue line, but instead it's going to be turned over, there's another stick on the ice with Grimshaw. Batted down there, it's Rapatoxi, there's a hook in, that's a penalty, and that will be called. Looks like James Helens is going to be called for hooking Robert Oxley right in front of the Lions bench here. And then a pretty
cool someone else.
I think it's going to be Sean Galloway heading to it, even though he doesn't look too happy. I think the ref might have taken the wrong play there, but fairly standard call to make. The Stars aren't happy with the try in front of us clear as day, don't you think?
Yeah, well, they're never going to be happy about it. No team's happy about a ref. They always reckon they've made it wrong. But yeah, like you said, clear as day, straight on the hand. Can't really complain.
No, so Lions go on to the power play, win the face off. Shot early there by Summerton, saved by Brown. Out towards the corner for the Helens. Fisher turns it over, and the Stars can move back and clear the zone. It'll be dumped down. Lions this season, 6th best power play out of 9 in the league. 16.9% conversion rate, 22 power play goals compared to the Stars, who have the best penalty kill in the league, killed off 107 out of 125 chances, 85.6% on the kill. As the puck cleared out into the Stars bench, we'll get a face off just outside the Stars zone. I think the best stat in special teams, and really team stat for the Lions this season, has been their power play, 6th in the league, but best penalty kill in the league. It's going to be a tough one, especially against the best goalie in the league as well.
Yeah, they've definitely got to work out for his ball. All I've got left here. Minute 20, I'm sure we can get something going. Give it a big Luke Thomas. He knows what to do.
Yeah, Luke Thomas got a goal in the last home game on the National Ice Centre on the stream. That got a big roar from one of the fans here. It's got more goals than some of your skates, some of the proper skaters.
Yeah, that's just Luke for you. Greasy. Standing in front of the net. He, no goal to see around that big belly.
Maybe Brown can, best goalie of the league for a reason, potentially. Thomas Brown also played England on 23. There's going to be a shorthanded chance here for the Stars. Turning with it is Greg Tandy. Brings it back over into the neutral zone. Could have gone one-on-one with Ballinger. Played through the middle stretch pass, knocked over there by Patrick Strigorsen versus Landgrasser. Break out again with 50 seconds left on the opening power play of the game. It's with Tristan Grimshaw, stretch pass towards Toby Fisher, bouncing puck, heavy off his stick, but it's in the corner for the Lions on the far side, out towards Grimshaw again, at the blue line, shot in and saved there by Brown, and the rebound couldn't quite be collected by Summerton, and able to move 3-on-3 now off the start, move from neutral zone, slowly, winds up for a slap shot, there is Grittanden, shot there by Grigorzis, is blocked by Grimshaw, who's limping away, locked turn. The Lions have to move with 23 seconds left. 2-on-3 they go. It's going to be dumped down on net, cleared away by the pads of Brown. Back with Grigors. Dumped again. That's going to go on net. That's going to go just wider than actually a Ballinger. It's going to be Owen Davis with the four lines behind his end. This will be the rest of the penalty over and done with. Clearing the blue line there is going to be Oxley-Vez asking calls for a trip, but it looked like he cut across the body entire, Summerton will bring it back behind his own goal, Preston on the forecheck, out to the near side here then with Bahowski, Lions clear out for own zone, it's going to be turned over and neutralised, and back over red line, but Oxley wins the puck back quickly, Mervran over the blue line now on the near side, dumps it just wide of the net, not much on it, Oxley in the corner again, that's going to be rimmed round, and Harry Rushby's going to have to be quick to get this four of Lions, and he does so, first to it, but Parson turning, misses that, Preston for the Stars. Played round, but takes a bounce, a chance for Hauke in the middle, and Oxley couldn't quite get his stick down in time to take the deflection of the Stars, get away with one there in front of the net. Still 0-0 here on the Nottingham Lions YouTube channel. Spraggan, stick handling through the middle, going coast to coast across the ice, now to the near side with Galloway to the centre circle, shot saved by Ballinger, caught up straight into the chest, and the Stars kill off the first pounce of the game nicely, and then get a chance on the other end, but it wasn't all things considered a bad power play for the Lions. They had a few chances, but again, it's a tough one to break through with this Stars defence. Best in the league, best penalty kill in the league. It's a tough one.
Yeah, they're definitely a well-drilled team. They know what they're doing. They know where everyone needs to be. Oh, and just like that, they put one in.
Yeah, oh, almost out of nowhere. Stars win the face-off on the near side, just cutting through the middle there. Looks to be James Moss, and scrambling over Chris doesn't look like there's much as.
Looks like Gritton's got the last touch. I think Isaac made the first save and he sort of. I think Gritton was able to get his own rebound there, you know, with that big long reach and just twist it in round him.
Quickly done there. It was either Gritton's or Moss. We'll get confirmation of that in a second. But 1-0 to the Stars and 7:34 to play. And they win the face off straight away. Dump straight behind the line. Oh, on net with some pace there as Ballinger had to make a couple of saves.
Yeah, Gritton's credit over the goal.
It was Gritton who actually got the goal then. That will be his 42nd goal of the season.
So that's
in the playoffs. Looking in the Lions zone, just in front of the Lions bench. Going to be dumped down on net, bouncing, and Ballinger's going to have to be cited to that. Fingal with it in the corner, one time it round, but Summerton loses out of the battle there. Towards, on net, through traffic, it just goes wide of Ballinger and net. Dumped back down as pushed aside there was Owen Davis behind. Lions got chipped in front and the Hounds get a poke away. There was Summerton, and that's going to go all the way down. And we're going to get our only second icing call of the game. 6:40 to play here. It's 1-0 to Stars then on the Nottingham Lions YouTube channel here at the NIHL Division 1 North quarter final playoffs. I'm Dylan Pick and I'm joined by the lovely Luke Sheldon. And we'll be here for all of the game, hopefully, unless Luca decides to go stream on Twitch.
No, not yet. I've got to get ready for a game later.
Chance in front of the net again, but back turn there was Lucas Dowdle. Stick tied up there. Unable to clear the zone. Whoa. Hall does bring out the puck into his own zone and a a hit there by Somerton turning the puck over, and the Lions are getting a bit of possession of Hall. Just getting up to his feet now, struggling to get to an edge, but head down, clearing his own zone, then nearly turned over, but the puck bouncing just evaded Alex Preston. And calls for a nice, and that's waved off, although that came from a long way down, but linesman says otherwise, back in the Lions zone, that'll be cleared out a long way, and have to get your foot moving there, so this could be icing, but Griggles gets it for the Stars, brings it behind his own net. Stars look to break out, clear for own zone, for a neutral ice down the far side there. Grimshaw cuts across and hustles him off the puck, but assistance there behind for the Stars. Lions in the back, rimmed round, but kept in his own by Spraggan. Spraggan down to the hash marks on the near side towards Dowell, now with Paul behind the Lions' goal. Rushby pins him up, Dowell comes to assist, and Grimshaw's there for Lions. Orton Shaw as well helps on his way. Back behind the Lions' goal from the Stars player. Rushby with it off the boards, and Birchall couldn't quite get a stick to it and turn over towards Preston for the Stars. Cross through the middle. Now down to the top of the face of the zone. Hash mark shot through the middle and just wide of Ballinger's net. And Rushby to Bahowski. Lions able to clear the zone. It's going to go a long way down. That will go for icing. And it'll be waved off by the other linesman. So Lions can get a change in. Mervran's going to be quick to his. Stars got a tip on. Luke Thomas clears the zone and it's played out towards Josh Heyman, but that's lost quickly towards the Stars' defence, and the Stars have a bit of space to work with there on the far side, coming through the middle towards Elder. Wilkinson's waiting in the middle. Dangles his way past Luke Thomas, but gets a stick on the second time as that slows down, asking for an end to the face there, but there was never really any contact, trying to settle in quickly, getting his way on again. Was the Stars forward, falling over, chaos in front of the Lions bench, Luke Thomas was sat on by Elder as Wilkinson had a pass fed to him just behind. That will clear out of zone, and the Stars going to have to get back onside. Lions able to get a change, going to have to be quick, so the Stars might want to work with a bit of speed here if they do so. Elder coming through with the middle, waiting and shot just wide of Ballinger's net as the screen was coming through. Dan Martin. Now with Luke Thomas again in the corner on the far side. Cross ice D to D. Able to clear the zone with Somerton. Fisher and Somerton batting away with Galloway on the near side. Tripped down there by Galloway. Somerton is he sat on no call, but Fisher's there. But he's sandwiched between two of the Stars players on the Stars blue line. And Somerton's down on the ice. We'll get a whistle for an injury. Looked like there was almost a smooth foot there by Galloway in the neutral zone. Then he just completely fell on Somerton. No call. What do you make of that one, Luca?
Yeah, I couldn't tell from up here, but it looked like he lost his footing on either a stick or the puck itself, so obviously Susters seems to think he slipped on the puck, but who knows what he saw. But yeah, just fell on top of him.
Yeah, took a heavy hit. Sean Galloway, a big man for a 23-year-old, completely flattened.
Not at all, is he?
Back out into the star zone on net. Comfortably put away there by Brown. Playing cross ice D to D. Go over the Stars. That took an awkward bounce. And Toby Fisher's hard on the forecheck. On towards Galloway. But he just rims it round towards Griggles. To the opposite side. Just over the goal line there. Now playing it through the middle as the Stars come out for his own. Move a bit of space there. It's Moss. Brilliant stick out through the forwards of the line. It's through. Chance on net. Backhand off the side netting there, and Ballinger got lucky for us. He was not side to puck at all. Rebound, right shot in, off the netting again. Galloway with it. Now towards Moss, asking for it on the blue line for his Griggles on the left-hand side. Now towards Helens on the opposite side, down towards bottom of the face-off, through the middle, and Galloway couldn't quite get to the start, still with it. Chipped in there by Galloway, saved by Ballinger, cleared out towards the corner. Now towards Griggles again at the blue line. Hash marks on the far side, and we got a whistle for the net being off. And the Stars bench isn't happy with it. Helen's open space, and just before we get a shot off, it's whistled down. As a goalie, you'll be happy with that one. As a skater, probably not so much chance denied by the rest there for Helen's.
Yeah, I reckon Isaac had it covered all the way anyway. Maybe a little tactical kickoff on the net, who knows?
He made a very similar save early on. He's very good when it's sighted to him. When it's a bit of a screen this season, he's struggled a bit, but got a brilliant glove like yourself on him.
I told him well.
Stars within her own zone. Out to the far side with Helen Spraggan. Through the red line now in towards the line zone. He's got a wall of white in front of him. But he's still stick handling well. Backhand through traffic. But he's still with it. It's going to come out towards Grimshaw. He can't bat it down and it's still in the line zone. Lucas Dowell backhand it in towards the far side corner of the line zone. Rushby gets to it first, but he's tied up between two of the Stars players, so can't quite clear his blue line. When he out of that though is Luke Birchall. He dumps it and he's got some space to work with it. Birchall, quick on his heels. Spraggan blocking him. Birchall behind his own net. Now in front of the Stars net. Oxley couldn't quite get a stick down to come out towards Dowell, but it was brilliant work by Birchall to clear the zone and get a breakaway. Still in the zone there for the lines, and Miller keeps it in. Bahowski on the far side is going to turn over and Stars can work with a bit of speed here. Coming 2-on-3, poked away there by Parson, but can't do much. Lions have made a costly error, they've had a chance to break away, but back turn can't do much. But on a change both sides, Bahowski out towards Heyman, but it's too far away from Heyman and the Stars. Back within their own zone, stretch pass away. It's high in the air, but Bahowski can't get to an elder. Through the middle, fires a shot on, save by Banner, tripled out! And it collects his own rebound. Banner didn't have it. It trickled through his legs. An elder wise to it. Banner doesn't look too happy about that.
No, he won't be.
Costly error, and the Stars make it two.
Yeah, that's one of those things that happens sometimes. Especially with all that kit on. You think you've got it, but it just finds a way to trickle through, and obviously. Elder there, man of the moment, gets his own rebound. Moves quick for a big guy.
Yeah, quick for a first trial, 25th goal of the season. Elder, 7th in the league for goals in the regular season. The former GB University and player in the 2014 Winter University and gets his first goal of the playoffs. And great awareness from the Stars captain. No one but Elder seemingly knew that puck wasn't safe with Ballinger. That's going to go all the way down the line to call for an icing. Nothing, and you're not happy about that one, and I'm confused why that wasn't an icing either.
I think the rest want to go for an early period break here. They don't want to drag it out.
Yeah, 40 seconds left in the period, through towards Wilson in front of the goal, and snatching it there was Elder. Back door wide open, but couldn't quite get to it. Stars with it, top of the blue line. Out towards the far side, hash marks, Wilkinson couldn't get enough of it. In the blue, paint, it just trickles away. 20 seconds left, the Lions might just want to hold on to it here, but it could get a chance to break away 3-on-3. Through the centre circle with Fisher, out to the far side, dumped early. Brown didn't have all of it, but Fisher wasn't quick to the rebound. Couldn't do an elder. Galloway with mouth and Stars over his own blue line, now through far side of the neutral zone. Rim Brown, shot on there, into the pads there, and Ballinger doesn't look too happy about it. We've ended off the first period after 20 minutes. The visitors lead 2-0 with a late goal in the period from Michael Elder. But all things considered, the games with Stars team 24-8 in regular season compared to yourselves 5-23-4. What do you make that first period, Luca?
I mean, it's not a bad period, obviously. 2-0, end of one against a team like Bellingham. It's really not a bad score considering it was 1-0 up until obviously that little blip at the end there. But I mean, it just looks like we're on survival mode at the minute. Obviously, we've had a few chances, a few breakaways, maybe odd man rushes, but we need to start taking them. There's no point in us, you know, crossing the blue line and flowing one in from the blue line. You know, Brown's too good of a goalie. He'll just either catch it, control it, send the rebound into the corner. He knows what he's doing. We need to get down and dirty. That's what we need.
Well, you've not got time to get down and dirty.
No.
What do you think for going into the second period? You need to make improvements on. So obviously, there's a lot of heads down passing, not much awareness on the ice. When you have been able to connect those passing, get the breakaway chances, you've not been too bad, especially when you're without like your Nick Martin, your Kieran Gibbs, and your Kiama. What do you need to do to make up for those losses?
We just work together. We need to give each other an option, you know. Part of the reason we're just sort of whacking it anyway from behind is there is no out. You know, people are looking up and seeing all the people, all the options marked. So they're just hitting it, hoping it, and then like we said earlier, we just trapped in the zone for 3 minutes at a time, and that's not going to do good for anyone. So we need to just use each other, use the options, and start using our brains a little bit. Play smart hockey.
Well, myself and Lucia will be back in about 15 minutes time here on Varsity Online, YouTube channel 4. The second period coverage on the Varsity Online YouTube channel radio coverage will continue about 50 minutes time of this NIHL Regional North playoff quarterfinal between the Boston Lions and the Millennium Stars. Do not go anywhere. Okay, so this is the end of the first period here at the National Ice Centre between the Lions and the Birmingham Stars. Stars leading by 2-0. Shots on goal in that first period are 16 for the Stars and just 3 for the Nottingham Lions. This is just us trying to sort out the audio for you for the rest of the game, seeing if we can make it sound a little bit less robotic. We thank you for bearing with us. This is our first live commentary from the arena since 2017, and it's our first radio commentary since we got the Pixel Lock camera about 5 years ago. So we thank you for bearing with us, and don't know if this is sorting the issue out or not, but hopefully it is.
Yeah,
we're doing an interview with Lupe Sheldon now. Lupe, you were on Radio Nottingham a couple of weeks ago talking all about your Twitch channel and how it is being the backup for the Panthers. I know as I came round from the announcer's box, Laura, the physio, just arrived as well. So the team, it's a really crucial part of the season, isn't it? Because Panthers have to win at least two of the games and they have to win at least one of them this weekend.
Yeah, no, we've been talking all about it. We know what we need to do, and just guess it's about going out there and doing it now in itself. You know, we're all looking forward to it. It should be a good, exciting couple of games.
And how are you finding your first experience of doing Lions commentary?
It's pretty exciting. Yeah. I feel cool being up here with the headset on. So maybe it's the future, eh?
Yeah, welcome to the media world. Yeah, I mean, how do you think Ice is getting on? 16 shots against him in that first hit. Made some very good saves.
He did make some very good saves. That's a solid game, actually. He's kept us in it. Obviously, maybe he'd won the last one back, but it's always... I never really like saying that about goal, you know, they won one back, because they are still difficult, you know. You think you're better, you don't quite feel it slip out of the back. It happens to anyone. I've had plenty of goals I've laid from the opposition blue line or goal line or things like that, so...
I think he's having a good game, though.
I think for Isaac, the big thing is in... Obviously, the head to the heavens, the sort of thing that every goalie does, and even players do when you make a mistake like he did, just trickled through his leg. He made the initial save, but he didn't look overly bothered. We've seen him earlier in the game where he's had a few go through, and he just completely loses his head. I think it's still early on in the game. The Lions can get a bit of luck. They did have their chances. Whilst it was second half of the period, it was pretty much all Stars. But a couple of lucky goals, they could be in it, and anything can happen tomorrow as well. I think the key thing for Isaac is not lose his head. He's still got 4 minutes play. If he gets frustrated, I think when the goal happened, it was a good time. To make a mistake like that, it's a good time, 40 seconds before the period ends. Because 40 seconds, you're off from a change, you've got 15 minutes to compose yourself. You do that start period, you've got 30 minutes on the ice of that weighing on you, and that can spiral, especially when it's late. So I think there's never a good time to make that sort of mistake and let one in. But if there is a time, I think that's probably the best time. I don't know what you'd think, Luca, as a goalie, but I think that's probably the best time for that mess up to happen.
Oh, that is a tough one. I mean, it can go one of two ways, really, can't it? It really depends on how you take it. Either he goes into the period and he beats himself up 14 minutes and, you know, he has to sit and stew with it rather than being able to make that next save. Or alternatively, he does. He goes in and he thinks, you know what, I've got 14 minutes now to chuck some water in my face, maybe punch my blocker a few times. Well, knowing Isaac, I think he's good at that, you know. He's good at taking the goal, putting it behind him, and you have to be a goalie. So I've got faith in him. I reckon he comes out here and stonewalls him for two periods. What do you reckon?
Yeah, that's, hopefully that's what happens, and the Lions can keep this score respectable. 2-0 then at the end of the first period, and 9.5 minutes to go until the second, so we'll take a short break and be back for the second period.
Oh, it stings, man.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to the Nottingham Lions YouTube channel. I'm Dylan Pick, and joining me for the second period of this NIHL Division 1 North quarterfinal playoff between the Nottingham Lions and the Billingham Stars. We're not only joined by Luke Sheldon, the EIHL Supersonic Pants Netminder, but we're also joined by the number one, the golden boy of the Nottingham Lions, currently suspended, as predicted. Top scorer, fifth in the league on goals. He's got 30 goals this season, 18 assists, and 97 penalty minutes. It's Zach Yokoyama, ladies and gentlemen. Hello,
thank you,
Zach.
Thank you. Oh, anybody.
anybody that
sees me.
We need to mention he's also first in the league in penalty minutes. Is that a shock to anyone?
I'm trying to hit 100, but I've been banned, so.
Yeah, but maybe, well, to be fair, I would say maybe Lions can win and go over to Sheffield in April, but you'd still be banned.
Yeah. Unfortunately, but it is what it is.
So, what do you make of the game then, Zach? Your expertise as a forward, at the end of the period, me and Luca said that breaking out, the Lions need to be a bit more clinical, a bit more heads up. As the expert player, what do you think we need to do?
It's a fast game. I think we need to skate more with a puck. Get a bit more shots on net, generate more offense. But other than that, I think they're being a bit solid in the defensive zone.
Could we potentially get like a makeup specialist, make you look like Luke Thomas? He can go home and spend some time with his newborn and you pretend to be Luke Thomas.
Ooh, what do you think about that one, Nick?
Listen, I don't want to be the one to say it, but there's a big difference between the two of them. One of them is...
What, in skill or size?
Both.
Both. Luke's better.
Yeah, exactly, got a goal.
Oh,
well,
wow.
We already then faced off for the second period, and it's one out by the Stars, bringing it down. The near side is Dowdle. Stars now shooting right to left, and the Lions already making a bit of a mistake in their own zone. Ending up clearing tower, that's going to go a long way down, and this should be the first icing of the period, waved off by the linesman. Luca again not happy with it. That'll be chipped on there by Chris Sykes. Going to be chased down by Sam Miller, looking a bit slow, and he beats Wilkinson to the race. But turn over to Chris Sykes there by Dan Martin. A mistake that he's not normally on to, and losing an edge there is the second goal scorer, Elder. That'll be chipped down in front of Netton. Took a deflection, saved by Ballinger, and gets the rebound. Well, we said in the little intermission show we had that Isaac needs to keep his cool, and he's come out the second period, not bothered at all, and makes a big double save there.
Yeah, it was a cheeky shot there from Sykes. I don't know if you could see from up here, but he basically just volleyed that in the net. You know, he kicked it. So even if that had gone in, it wouldn't have counted. But it's good for Isaac and his confidence to make them saves.
Zach looks like a very proud man with his teammate on comms. Chance off the face-off again by Gritans. Poked away there by the Lions defence. Turnover by Gritans again. Luke Birchnell wins it back. Luke Bertrand's been having a few turnovers, but he's been winning them back instantly. And again, an example there happens, and he's flattened into the board, stays on his feet just about, though, and Grimshaw's going to poke it away. Comes out towards Moss, but it's over the blue line into the Lions zone. Back over again with Helens. Oxley loses it to Grigors. Grigors with it in the Stars zone, out towards Galloway on the near side on the red line. Dumped down behind the Lions goal. Ortonshaw pick it up, chased by Moss. Again, awkwardly off the boards by Ortonshaw. Rimmed round towards Birchnell. Birchnell hustled by Hall. It comes out towards Walls, near side blue line. Shot in, and that nearly took a deflection of Ortonshaw's stick, but went wide off the net in the end. And Oxley, well, fans poking it away. And he's going to play that right out towards Gritans. Chance in front of the net, and Wall couldn't get there in time. And being pushed over there is Oxley asking for a penalty behind the net there. And the Stars fans finally getting in voice for the first time. First shot on net by the Lions. Poked away there by Brown. Stretch pass, cross for Housky. Couldn't quite get to it. A chance to break way through. Stars 2-on-1. Round goes Google. Shot wide of the net there. And Ballinger never had to move a muscle to do that one. Bouncing away in towards the corner on far side. Bahowski misses his hit on towards Preston. Now be tied up by two of them. Bahowski pokes away, but Preston, good strength there. Behind the Lions net, they've got options waiting in the middle. Plays out towards the hash marks though with Lucas Dowdle. Back behind now for Lewis Hall. Waiting in the middle where is Hall. And now Bahowski has a chance to turn and go. And quick skating there by Walls. Not only back checks it off past the Murran, but keeps it onside. Trickles out again, but collecting it. Lions asleep, not with it. And Stars fans in good voice here. And the net off, and the Stars fans definitely not happy about that. I think Ballinger's kicked that one out, and a few expletives shouted from the Stars fans, and you don't look too pleased about that one, Luca.
Well, what do they know? They don't know what they want about. No, I didn't mean that. We have before that. Have all the fans here.
Oh, I respect fans always.
Yeah, it wasn't great for Lions. They had a chance to break out a couple of times there. I think if that was used, that could have been down for your friend and a shot on Brown on net.
Yeah, he'd have probably scored knowing Zach. He doesn't miss the net very often, this kid.
Fancy dangle, which way? What do you prefer, shoot backhand or forehand?
Well, forehand, I suck on the backhand.
Why do you normally shoot on your backhand then when you deke?
Burn.
He doesn't know what he's doing, that's why.
Where's my goals on lock anyway?
Yeah, he panics.
That's going to go all the way down towards the lines, and it'll be the first icing call for the Stars this game. And we'll go all the way down to the Stars zone face-off coming up. A number of games, Zach, where you had about four chances breakaway, one and over the goalie. Did you fancy Deke? All four times on your backhand, and it was covered well. I think it was the Hall Jets got a good goalie. First time shooting your forehand top shelf.
So is this just rinsing Yokoyama tonight, eh?
No, I'm just proving your point, but your forehand's better. I remember. Well, we'll get back
there
to
it
in a minute. Chance for Sykes breakaway.
Well defended by Tyler Summerton.
Very well defended. Very good kid.
Chance now for Toby Fisher. Is going to be in a wall of four Stars players. Shot over the blue line. Dumped down. Didn't have much options. Chases his dump, but it's going to be picked up there by Helens for the Stars. Stretch pass out towards Sykes. Drops it back towards Wilkinson. Gains the blue line. Waiting in the middle there is Sykes. Turn over though towards the lines, and now Dan Martin has a chance to break one on two. Bring it down the near side here, round into the corner, played into the middle, but no one's there. But Summerton collects it. Shot in, rebound there. Justin Finetting off the stick of Dan Martin.
Thought Franchise Fish was going to have an option there. He looked like he was dangerous in the slot, but.
Went in for that one tee.
Yeah, exactly. Turns out he cannot get a stick on it. Maybe he needs to get a longer stick, who knows.
Get the length of the higher rush be stick.
Nah, true.
Well, I made the point about the shot because I remember making a comment about it on the stream, but the first time you changed your tactics up, you absolutely buried it on a goal. He was having a good day, and why didn't you do it more often?
Don't ask us. We're not in charge of the tactics.
Brilliant stick handling nonetheless. I think the Jets goalie did well to deny you on multiple occasions there. It was a tough one to beat. Both goalies that final Hall Jets game in good nick. There could be a chance for Lions. Oxygen have to be quick skating. Tries lifting the stick of the 19-year-old Spraganak. It comes out on net, and Brown thought about covering it, but plays it onwards. And the Stars have been under pressure a bit here this period by the Lions. They've had a few chances. Webb was said in the dressing room after the first break, someone's come good. But Stars with it behind the Lions' net, and has got a bit of space. The point, all three point men completely left open. Now towards the hash marks, and that was poor by the Stars. Spraggan back turn. Not much communication there by the Billingham players there. Nearly coughed it one up. But back towards Spraggan at the blue line. Plays it low through traffic, and Ballinger just about gets it. Rebound comes out. Couldn't get the shot off, though. And trying to move quickly there is Oxley diving down. Couldn't quite clear the blue line. Coming over again was Birchnell, but again he couldn't do it. But the line still with possession. Birchnell now with it. Just about clears the blue line, and Stars have to circle back onside. And now the line's moving with it, but head down and expletives from the Lions bench, not happy, a bit of frustration setting in. They need to build back into the game here. Chance for the Stars moving over. Shot scores! Oh, what a snipe that is there by the Stars player. Preston moving over the blue line, top of the face-off zone, just snipes it. Those sort of saves that Ballinger's been good with all season, and a grimace on your face there, so like you don't look too pleased, but it's a brilliant goal.
That is a shame.
Alex Preston.
There was a lot of mishaps before that goal happened, which allowed that occasion. Unfortunately, we didn't get the puck deep. Mikey missing the puck in the middle, but mistakes happen. Unfortunate goal.
3-0 to the Stars, and the thing we spoke about with Lions, each changes. We need to work on the breakouts. We need a bit more heads up playing. A couple times we had chances, but heads down, and then it leads to a Stars goal. They get their third. 5 minutes into the second period, and we're on the attack already again. Out to the middle, chance, rebound, can't get it, and falling down. We're going to have a delayed call on the trip.
Pull that arm down. Oh my goodness.
Luca's not happy with it at all here.
Guys just dived in front of the net.
Played out through towards Helens. That'll be touched up there by Finn Wall. And for the first time this game, the Stars go on the power play.
That kid, some armbands diving like that. Oh my word.
Didn't know we were going swimming.
Kids lost.
Wow.
in front of Fournette there. In front of Ballinger's net, the puck was loose. About four Lions players and two Stars players. Potentially a stick left out maybe. We can't quite see who's in the box. It's one of the youngsters. It might be Luke Birchnell. Face off one by the Stars out towards Spraggan. Now down towards the hash marks. Blue line on the far side. Now to the near side of Spraggan again. Cross towards Britann. Spraggan with it. Shot low off the blocker and into the glass there. Good save by Ballinger. Rimmed, failed out towards Elder. Now Spraggan. Spraggan cutting cross, drops up to Elder at the top of the face-off circle. Shot in, glove down through traffic. Ballinger with the best save of the game so far.
Very good save. Well watched all the way in. Just for the record, that is passing in the box. Still, for the record, I think it's a terrible call, but we move. Good save from Isaac.
Maybe that's why you're up in a box and not in the stripes.
Hey, I actually used to be a ref, you know.
Oh, dear.
Yeah, that's what many people said when I got showed up, bro. Yeah, I was linesman. Linesman, did a bit of reffing. Some would say the greatest ever put the armbands on.
Stars with the second best power play in the league in the regular season. 24 power play goals from 8 to 10 attempts. 27.5% on the power play compared to the Lions having the 8th best penalty kills. 72 killed off from 98. 73.4 penalties killed off this season. A massive disparity there, even more so than the Lions' power play. That will be cleared out of zone by Fisher all the way down, and Brown will come out to touch that one up, and the Lions get a couple personnel changes with Birchnell coming on for Fisher. Down the near side, down the far side, sorry, with Wilkinson as he turns over the blue line. Down towards the hash marks now for the Stars. Spraggan with it in the corner, behind the Lions net waiting for options. Round it goes to the other side towards Wilkins. Helens waits at the blue line, it goes towards him. Walls is to his left, he drops it back towards Spraggan at the hash marks on the far side. Shot off the pad there of Ballinger. And Coach Matt Bradbury for the Lions asking for some quick skating. There could be a chance here for Luke Birchnell to go short-handed. Down through the crease, he gets held up a bit. But it's brilliant. Time killed, and Summerton might have a chance if he's quick to it, but thinks better of it. And Stars come with it through the face of zone with Wilkinson, turns at the hash mark back towards the blue line with Helens as they go for a change. We'll get set up again. Final few seconds in the pass and penalty. Shot across the crease again, but through the paint, nothing touching it. Out of the box then is Parson. Even strength come the lines and dumped down instantly in Summerton. Will chase, no icing on the play. Helens with it for the Stars. Turning to his left there. Through towards Sykes. Sykes with it for the Stars. Poked away there by Finwall. Finwall off the ball towards Dan Martin. Dan Martin full stretch out, gets it. Bringing it down in front of the goal. Chance for Dan Martin and saved there by Brown. Cheeky stuff attempted there by Dan Martin, but Thomas Brown had it all the way. Stretch pass attempt blocked by the Lions. It's falling over there. In the centre ice was Michael Elder. Griggles with it, shot off of the leg of Owen Davis. Turn over at the blue line. Moss chance save there off the blocker of Ballinger. And Stars really ramping up the pressure now. Shots from everywhere. Griggles far side. Blue line nearly taking a tip off of Moss's stick, but it goes through and around the net. Back out towards Galloway at the hash marks on the near side here. Through the crease. Dan Martin now for the Lions. Lions clearing ground zone through the middle towards Fisher. Fisher one on two gets through. One of them brought down. No call. Not happy with it there. There are a few of the coaches on the Lions bench. Lucas shaking his head and the Stars come the other way with a bit of speed. It's Spraggan gaining the blue line. Dropping it back towards Moss. Moss, bit of a deep save by Ballinger. Leg full stretch out and Davis. Pass it behind Vett towards safety from the rebound. Turning there is Summerton. Round towards Sam Miller on the near side corner. Brings it back round and allows his team to set up for a breakout. We need to get heads up here. And that's a heavy touch and turn over. And commentators curse with Lions winning it back and full stretch out there. Summerton backhanded pass behind towards the virtual. Luke SP chance and save there by Brown poking it away. But the best bit of play from the Lions so far. Summerton and Birchnell linking up. Cheeky backhanded pass. Straight through the middle. Space on Veneers on the far side. Sorry, shot. Save there. And around. And it goes by Ballinger. Dowdle out towards Galloway. Chaos on Veneers side as Both teams tried to set up a formation out towards the blue line, out towards Dowdle. Right in front of the Stars bench, stick on it there by Birchall, quick away. Grimshaw couldn't quite clear the blue line, and in front now, Galloway shot, scores! That's the fourth for the Stars! Left wide open, the red light rings in front of block 10 here at the most point, and the Stars starting to run away with it here. They went to the second half of the game, Grimshaw had a chance to clear it, couldn't quite get to it, and you don't look happy, Zach, what do you make of that one?
Yeah, it's just unfortunate, if Justin got there, we had a little breakaway. But a bit too short, like Lucas said, maybe get a Rushby stick on there.
Yeah, it's what we've been saying all period, all game. Lions, we're just panicking. It's as simple as that. We get the puck behind the net, we get it. We don't like we could set someone up to make a move, and we just fumble it around the board straight back to them. And we, you know, if we want to get some out of this game, we got to stop doing that.
What do you make of the chance for Birchnell there?
Yeah, that was good, but you know, he's a young kid. He's still.
How old is he? Like 16?
16.
Yeah, so he's young, isn't he? 16?
Can't find his name. Yeah, 16.
Yeah, exactly. So, you know, he hasn't had the experience of getting an opportunity like that. It looks like he just took a touch too big. Maybe didn't trust his speed. He's got to remember that if he gets going, people like Helens, they're not keeping up with him. So, you know.
You know, certainly a lovely backhanded pass from Tyler Summerton to create the chance, but now with Helens, all through traffic, saved there by Ballinger once again, and played out through in towards the Star Zone by Bahowski. Lions open up a bit of space and coming through in the middle, 2-on-1 for the Star, shot saved off the pad there by Ballinger, coming across his crease, Sykes with it, and Ballinger with his back turned towards the net, out of position massively, but the Lions defence back checking hard, getting the goalie out of a bit of trouble, thanking him for the saves he's made this game, and now Fisher with it, can't clear it, and it will be poked away by Harry Rushby. Summerton full touch out, couldn't get to it, and Grigors with it for the Stars in his own zone, circling away. Out towards neutralised, through the centre circle is Sykes. Sykes, full stretch turnover, rookie mistake there from the experienced Stars forward. Still with the Stars, Spraggan, the channel opening through the middle. Wilkinson dumps it out, can't bat it down, and Rushby gonna have to be quick to any pins the Stars forward against the boards. Out towards the blue line again for the Stars. Down through, circling across the top of the face-off dot is Sykes. Now towards Elder. Takes his time, plays it through. Couldn't get it on towards Sykes' stick and walls. A bit of confusion there with Wilkinson. Wilkinson kind of left the puck in no man's land. They had to get to it and try playing it through the crease, but the Lions with it. That'll be dumped down and not cleared zone by the linesman. Linesman eventually just say offside. Bit of a consolation because the linesman did stop it going offside. Good call. Elder doesn't look too pleased about it, but I think that's the right thing to do from the linesman there.
Yeah, I mean, obviously it works out well for us in our favour, but I don't think that puck had quite gone out, but, you know, we'll take it. So thank you to the linesman there.
Potentially maybe because it came off the linesman's leg, however, though he denied it. Don't know if you're necessarily out to do that, but it's potentially something that should be, because there's a lot of times that the Lions do end up blocking stuff like that. But caught short-handed here is going to be the Lions. Moss moving through, backhanded pass, it takes deflection, bouncing away, shot save there from Galloway. It's in the crease and comes out towards Galloway off the blocker.
Save.
Ballinger coming across, gets a round of applause from the Lions fans. Galloway winds up for a one-timer, dummies it, pass out towards Grittans, through to crease. It goes, Galloway will pick it up on the near side. Round towards Grimshaw. Have to be quick to it as Grittans lays up a hit, but Grimshaw can firm it nicely. Over the blue line it goes for the Stars. They'll have to come back onside with Spraggan. Spraggan circling in his own zone, nearly turned over there, but Birchnell was tied up and the Stars get out of trouble. Drop backhanded pass towards Spraggan from Moss. Back towards Moss behind the Lions' goal. Now Spraggan at the boards, coughed up then, there's going to be a chance for Birchall to move once again. Birchall moving 2-on-1, dumps it and will allow himself to go for a change. Back with Oxley though, the young defenseman for the Lions. Potentially a hook in there, but no call. But Bahowski coughs up, there's going to be a chance here for the Lions, but pass and back turned again. That's the way for the Lions to get back onside, and the linesman calls offside. Well, delayed offside to get back on it. Shot there from Preston into the leg of Captain Luke Thomas. Through the middle there, it misses.
You tell him, Rushby.
Stick. Through the middle it goes again, but never troubles the goal. Out towards the blue line. across to the left side with Hellens, through the middle, off the stick there of Preston's. It bounces across the face-off zone on the far side. Bahowski with it. He'll be able to clear his own with a bit of speed. Lions could break away back in the pass. Aimed at Josh Heyman, but no communication. He had his back to it again. Still with Heyman now. Gets it in towards the star zone, but coughed up, no one there. Dowdall moving with it. Shot over the bar there as and over the glove of Ballinger. Lions not been able to make much of it so far. A bit of sustained pressure here from the Stars. Hellens couldn't quite get a one-timer as it bouncing through the crease as Hall stick lifted, couldn't get a tip on. Out towards Dowdall on the far side. Now with Hellens near side, top of the face-off, behind the goal line again for Preston. Preston turns, shot off the leg of Luke Thomas, full stretch out for an old man. That's quite impressive. Round again behind the goal, in front of net. Now to the face-off, shot save there by Ballinger. And that will be kept in the zone there. And Barnes will be able to get a change on forwards. You have to be quick though. Hellens gaining the blue line. Outnumbered there, Lions in their own zone, coming through. Good stick there by Orton Shaw. Gets him out of trouble, and Dan Martin couldn't quite get a hold of it to go at a breakaway. But he will rim it round towards Toby Fisher on the opposite side of the ring. That's going to be poked away there, and that's poor from the Lions, number 14. With the in their own zone, and the boys in white and gold. Orton Shaw turning over in his own zone. He have to get back, but pass from the line from the Stars players. And trouble and chance for Dan Martin poked away. Rebound from Fisher. He can't bat it down. And you can hear Luke Sheldon unhappy on a change line. Chance to get a bit of luck and can't be with it. I'm sure Zach's thinking if that was me, I would have buried it.
No, Zach would have fell over and missed it. But we just need a bit of puck luck, you know. It just happened to bounce just the wrong way.
Somerton shot save there by Brown. Didn't look comfortable. He's a relatively cold goal. He's not seen many shots. Through the middle. Oh. Fisher couldn't get onto it in time.
Fish!
Shout out to his teammates there from block 15, the commentary box. It is Lucas Sheldon. But a couple of chances there from the Lions. And the Stars come back the other way. Shot wide of the net. Wilkinson dumps it round behind the goal towards Sykes. Played out towards Elder at the bottom of the face-off zone. Across to the man waiting and on the far side, Grigor shot, saved by Ballinger, can't get a rebound. Shot in towards a skate there of Grimshaw. Out towards Elder at the hash marks, far side. Across out towards Grigor's. Grigor shot over the net and gloved down actually by Ballinger. Through traffic again, he's doing well to deal with Emlot.
Yeah, that's a very good catch.
Playing second period score is 1-0, sorry, it's 4-0. To the Billingham Stars here on the Nottingham Lions YouTube channel. I'm Dylan Pick taking you through play-on-play audio coverage of this NIHL Division 1 North quarter-final playoff first leg. I'm also joined by the lovely Luke Sheldon and Zach Yokoyama. Hope you're all enjoying the commentary by the Panthers goalie and the suspended Lions top scorer here. Face-off won by the Stars. We're asking for a whistle. It looks like someone's been hit to the head. No call. Shot coming in, that'll be gloved down by Brown and he'll cover that up. But a heavy hit there as Moss caught one off the face off, stick out his hand, possibly a missed call there. Lions at a breakaway, but not much. I don't think Luke Birchnell really troubled it. Potentially out of respect, wasn't the greatest of shots. And helmet off there for Moss. Can't see if he's bleeding, but he looks hurt. But he's off, and we'll see what the rest decide to do with here. 2:53 to go then, Yokoyama dancing away. What do you think, expert forward Zach? What do the Lions need to do in the final 3 minutes?
I think we get a few more shots on there, we possibly get a goal. If we get one goal right now, hopefully we'll be going into the third with a bit more positivity. What do you think, Luca?
You know, I agree here with you here, Zach. I think the Lions just need to push on here, maybe get a goal. If we get a goal in this next 2:53, we are living chilling. No one knows what's going on here. Looks like Susters has maybe made a call. What are we listening to? Bench side. There's no way he's making a call here. If he's making a call here, this is purely a reactionary call based on the fact he's seen the guy injured. He didn't see what happened. He had no idea.
He wasn't called.
No. He has no idea what's happened here.
I think what happened from my perspective... I think from my perspective, it looked like it should have been a penalty, but obviously the ref didn't see it. So I don't think the ref should be able to call it after the injury when they've not
seen
it.
That was called by the linesman. I don't think a linesman can do that. But hey,
no, they can't.
It is, I guess.
And if you purely want to back up the point that we're making here about the ref making a call up, I'm not pointing fingers. He has called Luke Thomas here for a 2-minute penalty. Luke Thomas was not even on the ice in that shift. So make of that what you will.
Yeah, Luke Thomas is going to sit 2 minutes for high sticking when he was on the bench. That's a monumental mistake there by the referee. I agree it should be a penalty from what happened. The ref didn't see it though, so they shouldn't call it purely on reactionary. And they've definitely got the wrong man in the box there. So it'll be a 2+2 for the injury though, being told by the Lions bench. So there'll be a minute in the third period where the Stars will be on the power play. Second power play of the game for the Stars. Lions killed off the first one. The Stars have a bit of momentum, winning the first face off and slowly building up their formation.
Why was the blood? Hey.
I thought you could only call a 2+2 with blood, but I stand corrected.
I think it should only be 2+2 for blood, but behind the net, thought about the wraparound, potentially a mischief. Have you ever thought about one of them, Zach?
I will get a Michigan one time in my career.
No, I disagree. He hasn't got that in him.
Moss with it at the face-off dot on the far side. Cut across wide of the net.
That's what we call a field goal.
Is the shot. Spraggan with it at the blue line. That's knocked over. And the linesman didn't call offside, but I think everyone's seen it and it will go over in the end.
Linesman calling penalties, not offsides or ice in this game. Wild. Never seen that before.
Well, there's been a few icings that you think's been missed, Bev. Hockey players with high opinions, that's going to be cleared all the way down. Maybe they might call an icing here despite the Lions being on the power play.
Yeah, listen, I understand refereeing's a hard job. I think, you know, they get a lot of stick, but sometimes it's just crazy.
Stretch pass out towards Sykes. Shot coming in through traffic, it deflects. Never on net. Summerton trying to clear it, but it's kept in by Helens. Behind the goal with Spraggan. Tied up, we're asking for a hook. Ref lets it go as long as Davis lets go, and he does so on the ref's command. Behind the net with Helens again. Lone man, open save there by Ballinger from the oncoming shot by Sykes. 1:14 to play in the second period here. Lions, 2:12 left on the penalty. They'll start the third, as mentioned, on the penalty kill. Face off at the far side. Summerton steps up against Preston. Delay here for something. Linesman waffling on. They look a bit confused. They're going for the face off now. Third time's a charm, maybe fourth time's a charm. We get the drop and it's going to be tied up and it will be won out by the Stars. Slashing away at it. There was Owen Davis going to get to it now on the near side at the blue line with Wolves. Wolves stepping through to the top of the face off. Fanning the glove.
Great save.
Beautiful save. Gotta love that glove save.
Our two expert analysts in love with that one. And a big smile from Luca. You can't see it, but very popular on the Panthers social media. Everyone knows Luca Sheldon's big, white, cheesy smile.
Trying to make a career in social media influencing, maybe. See how it goes.
Wolves with it, final minute of play here. Top of the face-off, so on the far side, shot just wide of Ballinger's net. It comes out towards Helens. Right side, blue line, shot in! Covered it, sees it off way.
Oh, God.
Isaac Ballinger's glove is on fire with that many saves.
Yeah. Rub it in some ice, get the blaze out there. I don't mean like the NHL 2 blaze.
There's been a robbery, eh?
Daylight robbery, some would say.
You need to get on to social media lines to get them promoted this one. Imagine the views when they find out Lucas Sheldon's doing third period coverage. record numbers for the Lions here, and maybe Zach might get an NIHL national team.
Yeah, maybe.
Well deserved. He's had a great season. A few of the Stars players as well should be at least on a national team. Brilliant. A lot of them, Brown, Sykes, Gritans, and I've showed a class here today so far. Wilkinson shot into traffic at the near side, drops it back to the hash marks with Helens. Helens circles out through the middle, shot just wide of the net. Ballinger seemingly had it, and back out towards Wilkinson at the hash marks right side. Helens with it at the blue line. Shot wide again of the net, runs round towards Walls on the opposite side of the rink. Here at the near side, Galloway with it, plays it through towards the middle. Winding up, shot snagged, and that'll be the buzzer at the end of the second period. We'll have a minute and 7 seconds left on the power play at the start of the final period. But after 40 minutes of action here, the visitors lead 4-0 against the Nottingham Lions. What do you make of that period? Then another 2 goals gone in. Lions still search for the first. Do you think that looked better or first than the first period?
I think we looked better. Obviously, Luke had that chance. Kind of a mini breakaway. Dan Martin's had a few good skates. He's getting in there. I just think, if I'm honest with you, I think we were doing well. We're doing well to kill this penalty so far. Depends how this goes. This could be a make or break moment here. If we maybe let one in on this penalty kill early in this next period, you know, it could kind of break the back, but we'll have to see how it goes. Zach, what are you thinking, mate?
I'm thinking 2 goals in the first, 2 goals in the second versus the league winners. I don't think we're doing too bad, to be honest with you. We're missing quite a few players, myself, Croston, Gibbo. I mean, 3 extra players can definitely help the team a lot, but I think also this penalty kill's going good so far. So I think in the third period, if we come out strong, get 1 or 2 goals, motivation gets in there, kicks in, anything can happen.
Defensively, you lot have been great. Offensively, it's been a bit of a struggle, but that's kind of going to be that way. You're not going to get many chances against this Stars team. Not a few breakaways. What do you think, though, offensively, Zach, that the Lions need to do in the third period to at least get a goal, even if it's a consolation, get something on the board?
We need anything on net, even if it's a soft chip. Goalie can let go of anything if he's having a rough day. Drive the net. We need somebody on that net if there's a shot on it. There's no rebounds. Any goal's a goal. Dirty goal. Pretty goal. We just need anything. More shots and more driving the net.
Now, Luca, from a goalie perspective, how do you think Isaac's doing? Yes, he's at 4 and he had that mistake at the end of the first, but at the end of the period, there's some big saves on an extended penalty kill. What do you make of him so far tonight?
I think he's making it. He's having a good period, obviously. Oh, there we go. Before from, he's had 37 shots in 2 periods. You know, he's put near enough on a 90%. And yeah, we can sit here and we can say, you know, a few goals, maybe 1 or 2 he'd want back. But when you're getting towards the 35th, 36th shot of 2 periods, you've got to cut the kid some slack. Like, there's only so much you can do. Yeah, he wants them 2 back, but there's 10 others that he saved that maybe he had no right saving. So, and overall, he's not going to be happy with himself. He'll want to have saved, obviously, 37 out of 37. But from our perspective up here, I think he's doing a great job. So, keep going, Isaac.
Yeah, Thomas Brown as well in the Stars net. He's only faced 9 shots this game over 40 minutes. As a goalie, when you go so long without a shot, do you think it bothers you? If the Lions can get some shots on early, Brown's still going to be relatively cold. Do you think there's a chance that the Lions could maybe snag one if they're early whilst Brown isn't necessarily feeling awake to it?
Yeah, and I think like Zach said, the way we need to do is we need to get these shots on early. I don't think, if I'm honest with you, we're going to beat him with a shot from the blue line, these little things like the floaters that we send in. Because that's not to say they're bad shots though. Like Zach said, he can, even more so when he's cold, like you said, 9 shots in 40 minutes, he's not ready to do a lot. Even more likely he's going to spill one, maybe not send the rebound quite where he wants to. So we need to send people like Fish or Tristan or Michael or just anyone needs to crash the net and, you know, just shovel it in. Doesn't have to be pretty, just attack him, shovel it in, push him into the net with it, anything. We just need to get that puck in the net. Do you agree, Zach?
I completely agree. Them 9 shots, I don't think were very dangerous shots. So I think definitely in the third period, he's still going to be called. And if we get 1 or 2 proper, decent, grade-A chances and we bury them goals, he will start to get flustered.
Yeah, now we can kind of say we're in the second period into intermission sort of show. We'll bring Chris Gadsby, who's wandered on from the opposite side of the rink, in a minute. But from your two's perspective as a whole on the season, I mean, for a lot of the season, you were down in 9th outside of the playoffs. But since New Year, you had a big run. You got a few overtime points, got a couple of wins. That really jumped you up and the Scimitars kind of fell off. But you've got a very young team. A lot of them, if we look through now, we've got a load of 16, 17-year-olds. Parsons, 17. Dan Martin, 18. James Mather, 16. Harry Rushby, 19. Luke Birchnell, 16. Finn Waugh, only 18. Liam Orton Shaw, 16. Tyler Summerton, 17. Ethan Wilcox, 18. Robert Oxley, 18. Nick Martin, 98. I'm reading out the numbers here. 16.
Yeah, you know what's sad is that I'm 22 years old and I think I'm the oldest on that team.
Let's not forget Luke Thomas, shall we?
Okay, yeah, but Luke Thomas is supposed to be retired, so take him out of the equation. I'm definitely the oldest, I think.
Josh Heyman's 33.
Oh, thank goodness. Forgot about Josh.
Yeah, that, yeah, but you know,
we Jack Croson's 23.
Zandy's getting on a bit as well. But either way, no, you do bring up a very good point. Like, even the fact I know it's 4-0, but the fact we're still, it's 4-0 in hockey. That's not, the game's not over yet. You know, anything really can happen. But like you said, we've got a relatively young team. It's been that way for a while, you know. We've always been a team that likes to play the young guys, give the young guys a chance, you know. It's worked out in some aspects. I've been playing here since I was 16.
But in terms, and you now play for the Panthers, but in terms of development and how the season's gone for such a young team, compared to, look at the stars they've got, I don't know if you played with, did you play England under-23s, Zach?
Yes, I did,
Did you play with Tom Brown?
Yes, I did play with Tom Brown,
So, yeah, you've got experience there. You've got Andrew Finn, who played World Juniors with GB. I mean, you look at, where is he? Roland Gritan's resume. He's played in the Hockey Etana Swedish Third Division, the Russian Second Division in the VHL, the Kazakh Pro League, the Latvian Pro League, the French First Division in League Magnus, which, in the grand scheme of things, is only one league below the Elite League. And there's more. You've got Michael Edward, who played Universiade for GB. You've got a load of England under-23 players. Alex Preston, who also, like yourself, played high school prep in America. Tommy Spraggle on a two-way with some leads with the Leeds Knights. Chris Sykes has played GB as well. You've got a very young team. It's a very experienced. They've played loads of international experience. And that's kind of what it's been like throughout the season for you lot. Overall, what do you actually make of that? How do you think your team's done respectively compared to what you've got in the league?
Well, when the stats you just mentioned with all that, and it's only a 4-0 game, I think we're doing very well. When you look at those stats, you'd kind of hope and think that it'd be a bit more than just 4-0 just by those stats alone. But considering it's 4-0 again, I think we're doing pretty good.
Yeah, and I think on this season as a whole, I think we've only just missed out on a better spot. You know, there's been a few games that even I played in, I think we was, 4-3 against Blackburn. They scored in kind of the final few minutes. We've had a few overtime losses. You know, there's been a few results that... Holy yeah, but there's been a few results that could have gone out of the way, and that could have been a very different game right now. You know, we could have been in maybe 8th, 7th, 6th, 5th, something like that. And I'd say, other than Billingham seems to be a bit of a bogey team for us. We don't seem to be able to quite get as close as we'd like. We've been in these games throughout the seasons for a majority of the games. And with such a young team, I think that's, it kind of goes credit where credit's due. We battle these young kids. Yeah, they're young. Maybe not as experienced as Gritan's in the VHL or the leagues you said. But they battle hard, so hopefully we come out in this final 20 and put that hard battle into good use and get some goals, maybe go into tomorrow with just a two-goal, one-goal deficit and see what we can do.
Yeah, because that's all that matters. Anything can happen tomorrow. It's a two-leg game, but defensively, I mean, Gritan's hasn't had many chances, and he is effectively a former professional player. He's played in many pro leagues. I mean, and some good ones. The Swedish Third Division is very good. I mean, players from the Elite League come from there. The VHL, Second Division in Russia. Some great leagues, and you're holding them well. And I'll bring me on to my next point. Like I said, a very young team. A lot of 16-year-olds. First-year seniors against these veterans of British hockey. Who do you think potentially could make that next step? Not necessarily next year, but next upcoming years. Potentially get themselves on two ways, win over Lions, have a partnership with Pete to bring out themselves in NHL National, potentially yourself, Zach. What are the standout youngsters that you really think could make it? I mean, for me, the two standouts are Luke Birchnell and Tyler Summerton, but are any there, you're in the locker room with them week in, week out. Are there any special youngsters that you think could go a long way in their career?
Depends how you define young. I think Josh Heyman, he's got a few years left of his prime yet. But all jokes aside, I think one of the guys you mentioned, you know, Tyler Summerton, he's been a pretty standout guy. I think I can't remember why I was looking, but I looked at stats for that. Isn't he like third in the team points wise? Points or goals?
Points, and he was a long way back, but New Year, he really came up. Linking up with yourself, Zach, through a lot of home games, jumped Tristan and Toby in points. Toby, last couple of games, got himself back and secured second, but tied with Tristan for third on points. 17. He's an excellent player. He's second half of the season, he showed signs of like a younger version of Juzak and Isal. Quick skating, great stick handling, Do you think that's someone the NIHL national team should have on their radar for the future?
I definitely think so. I mean, when you consider that, although we are last in the playoff table, and he's still managing to get them points up, just shows that he actually can do something. When you put him on a team higher up in the league, let's say Solihull or D-side, just imagine the damage that kid could do if he was playing with people with a bit more goal-driven ideas and experience, especially.
Well, it's great insights. Unless there are miracles, it could be this probably will be the last coverage we get of the season on the Lions Youth Channel. So it's a great insight. There is a lot of young talent on the team, and it's great to kind of get yours two's input from the locker room of what there could be, because there is definitely potential for a lot of the players. But we'll take a short break. We'll be back in about 5 minutes for the third and final period. The Billingham Stars lead the home side of Nottingham Lions 4-0. Stars will start the third period with a 1 minute left on their power play. Do not go anywhere. Myself, Luke Sheldon, and potentially Zach Yokyam. We'll be back in about 5 minutes time. Do not go anywhere. Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to the Motorpoint Arena and the Nottingham Lions YouTube channel for radio coverage of this NHL Division 1 North quarterfinal first up between the Nottingham Lions and the Billingham Stars. I am Dylan Pick. Joined with me is the Panthers superstar of the Elite League, Lucas Sheldon. After four periods of Stars lead the Lions, four goals to shots. It's nine in favour of the. It's nine shots for the Lions and 37 for the Stars after 40 minutes. And for context, some teams don't even face that many shots in a game. For example, the Stars lead the league in the least amount of shots. They have averaged 31 shots a game that they face, whilst they shoot 42. That is second in the league. The Lions have averaged 41 shots a game, so maybe only four shots they face this period. That is eighth in the league, and also eighth in the league. Four shots, four with 33. We've got a long way to go to reach that one. Minute and 7 seconds left on the Captain Luke Thomas power play with the 2+2 for a high stick, which he was on the bench for, but he got called for, and that would explain why Luke Thomas went outtake that, as he was. It was a call that probably shouldn't have been given, but it was, as the refs finish off a discovery, or the discussion, as I should say. And we'll get ready for the opening face-off of the final period. Face-off's away, and it comes out towards the Stars. Won by the Stars out to the far side, gaining the zone quickly. Spraggan cross towards Gratanzu, coughs it up. That's Paul right in the centre of the near side face-off's circle. Once the Lions kick off this penalty, what do you think that they need to do here, Luca?
I think it's going to be quite a fine line, as maybe we get a 2-1 break short-handed. Here we go. That's a terrible pass. Well defended, but too slow. I think back to what we need to do. We need to sort of do a bit. Obviously, we need to remember it's a two-legged game. There's no point gunning right now to come back and win this game. Obviously, that'd be nice, but we need to work on maybe getting a goal or two and limiting the Stars' chances. As we break 2-1 again. Oh.
Delayed offside. Almost. The Stars have to circle back for a line change. Luke Birchall probably should just ran with it. Lines with a chance to go 2-1 shorthanded. Birchall tries playing it across to his right towards Dan Martin. Lions now shooting left to right. As the Lions go back to full strength and Luke Thomas is out of the box. But Luke Birchall has some speed. He probably should have just ran with it. And it could be a chance now dumping it on net as the Stars. But they'll just go for a change. And the Lions are picking up with Owen Davis, getting it off the net, and they'll be tied up. Ballinger covering his post to avoid any trouble. So turning to his left there. Look down towards the far side was Owen Davis. Moving across to Tyler Summerton. Summerton gained the blue line for the Lions. Grimshaw waits in front. Backhanded glove down! Best shot of the game there for the Lions. And Summerton, brilliant shot on his backhand. Awkward to do. And Thomas Brown sees it all the way and makes his first save. That's what we said in the period break. Get the shots on early. Brown relatively cold. He's only faced nine shots. That'll be his 10th.
Lions looking good in the opening minute and a half, you know. Near enough two short-handed 2-1 breakaways. So I mean, sometimes we need that look. We convert. There, he's dropped it. See, that's what we speak about. Shot from, we need them shots from the blue line. Brown's going to drop them. We just need someone to pounce on them rebounds. Well, there's example there. If you 2-1 breakers, convert one of them into 4-1. Someone's on that rebound, 4-2. You know, they're the margins that we need to just work on getting for ourselves.
Yeah, and you get two quick goals as well. The other team can start to collapse. I mean, the Stars have had a bit of a collapse. They've only won two of them.
Trish is away.
Game chance for Grimshaw. Rain and save.
Fucking maybe.
Mike Brown couldn't get the shot in. Luke thinks potential penalty, but we don't have the best view up here. No call for the refs at all. Still hoping for it. Luke Thomas in his own zone. That's poor though from Luke Thomas. Chance, no. The Stars. And Lionel and Fisher coughs it right up in the centre circle, but back towards the Lions. And it's slowing down a bit. It's the big man of Luke Thomas. Just about staying on his feet. He brings it round, dumps it into the Stars zone behind Ben. They'll go for a change. But Bahowski nearly forces a turnover. And Josh Heyman there taking a whack in. Again, fanning it a loose puck. And going all the way is Lewis Hall for the Stars.
Yeah, Lions, we've come out strong here. We've come out hard and strong, so doing kind of what we said we needed to do. We've got to be careful because all the Stars need is one chance. If they get one chance, one breakaway,
they're good at burying these goals, and that kind of would maybe take the wind out of the Lions' sails.
Yeah, you've had a habit of shutting off in the third period as well. We're going to have to definitely switch on for this final 20 minutes. Sam Miller with it in the far side in zone, clears the blue line, but it only makes its way to the Stars' blue line. Looking round towards Wilkinson now. Still in the Stars' zone, through the middle, chipped on, but it's turned over towards Harry Rushby in the Lions' zone. Try lifting it and sourcing it out. It will eventually be cleared with Tyler Summerton over the blue line, but the linesman skate knocks it down. A few personnel changes for the Lions and back in towards the Stars zone of Spraggan. The Stars currently struggling to break out a bit, but as we on cue stretch pass towards Wilkinson on the far side, drops it back top of the face zone by Eldon. Chipped on there by Wilkinson, wide of Ballinger and Vanette. That'll be high, but unable to clear the zone and kicking it out of the line zone. There is going to be Michael Elder, captain of the Stars, turning to his right there. Is Spraggan getting blue line again with Moss back, as you pointed out, from being injured. So not too much damage there. One time a shot wide of and over Ballinger's goal. Comes out towards Toby Fisher. He's got some time. Heads up and he might have some chance to go and skate with it. Through the middle he goes. Far side towards Summerton. Dumps it high onto the net of Brown. Dan Martin collects the rebound in the corner. Needing assistance there in front of the hash marks at far side. Clearing out, still in the Stars zone, spacewalks now. Awkward touch there as it comes in towards the Lions zone. The Lions will instantly be able to clear it, but it only goes as far as Galloway in front of the Lions blue line. Back in towards the Stars zone. The Lions have definitely, the first 5 minutes, have slowed down the game. Maybe the Stars have taken a bit off it, saved themselves for the second leg as Grittans cuts through, but that bounces away. But the Lions have definitely looked a lot better.
Yeah, you know, obviously, we don't know what's going on in with the Bellingham team in the room. Maybe they've decided they want to sit back, you know, maybe try and play a bit more passively, see how that works for them. But, you know, so far, Lions are keeping up with that. Maybe that suits us better, rather than them bobbing it down and setting up. Maybe them, you know, maybe they might be trying to save themselves for tomorrow, but that works in our favour.
Gets a chance and Robert Oxley cutting through on a breakaway, but poked away by Galloway, I believe that was, or Dowdle. It was Joe Dowdle poking away, denying the 1-0 from the young defenseman for the Lions. Coming the other way, 2-on-2. Sean Galloway on net, save by Ballinger, and coughed that one up. Looking comfortable. He's shrugged off that mistake in the first period, and we're having words with him just before the start of the third. He doesn't look too bothered, does he?
No, not too bothered. I mean, maybe coming out, obviously, when he came out and saw them shots, he kind of looked up and had a little smile. So maybe he sort of realised that he's been a bit harsh on himself, you know. 37 shots in two periods, as we said. There's no enough a shot a minute. That's, you know, that's crazy. Some goalies don't even get that in a game. Potential ball in there. Will Sust... No. Maybe not. Back to you for the play-to-play, though.
Yeah. Miller into the board. I wouldn't really call it a boarding, just holding up against. If anything, it might have been a holding call in behind the Lions net. It was never head first. Sam Miller wasn't too bothered, but the Stars come back the other way. 2-on-3 shot blocked by Sam Miller behind the net, telling Tyler something. He's got time, brings down his own net, drops it back towards the youngster Sam Miller. Played across to the near side of Summerton, moving in front of the Stars bench, dumped down to taking a tumble there. It was one of the Stars players, left his leg out there, was Grigors. Could have been called for a slew foot against the Latvian, but in the end, he ended up coming worse off, but Summerton couldn't get a shot on him, coming back 3-on-2. But brilliant back checking there by Dan Martin, and Summerton's going to have to be quick on his heels. Icing waved off as it's beaten there by Spraggan long before it gets towards the Stars goal line. Eldo, 1-2, back towards Spraggan, turning at the blue line. Tumbling with a stick handle, gains for blue line in Vienna, and Spraggan still going with it, trying to go all the way. Cocky 19-year-old, top defenseman for points on the team, fifth in the league for points by a defenseman. Tommy Spraggan had a great season from the 19-year-old, formerly with the Leeds Knights. GB under-18th players, well off the iron shot there by Elder, searching for a second of the game. Back through in towards a crease, poking away, and the Lions will be able to clear it out. Chance for a 3-on-2 breakaway. We need to move a bit of speed in towards Fisher. Fisher gets past one of them. Shot low, wide of the Brown in net. Summerton collects the rebound though, and he takes a bit of a time to poke it away, but doesn't do much. Still in the star zone, however. Cross towards Spraggan on the near side, moving through the neutral ice. Spraggan gaining the blue line. Out towards the hash marks. And they'll clear the line zone, but make it only as far as Joe Dowdle. Now Elder at the blue line. Cross the centre line they go with Joe Dowdle over the blue line. Now Chris Sykes, top of the line, faces on at the far side. Brilliant defensive work there by Tristan Grimshaw. He will win it back and rim it round. Time for the Lions to work with Owen Davis. Davis just sends it back behind his goal with Finn Wall. Now with Luke Burchill on to move with a bit of speed, poking away at it. There, that's going to be a tripping no call there. Lions bench not happy with it, neither is Lucas Sheldon, but Robert Oxley still going, and the Latvian, you'd think, Roland Gritand sticks right across the leg there of Luke Birchnell, bringing Birchnell down, no call. Referee to complete opposite side of the ice, not really sighted to it, so we'll give him benefit of the doubt. Finn Wall clearing the Lions zone, and Bahowski fanning on the dump. It's that sort of play again. Get over red line and dumping it over the blue line. You're not a fan of it. What do you think that Bahowski should be doing there?
No, I mean, in that situation, it kind of is the right play, but it sort of, it all stems from us. We get pinned in our own zones for a minute and a half, 2 minutes. We get across the red line, we dump to try and get a change, then we're just back on the back foot straight again. Yeah, but we need to just get better at this getting out.
Yeah, straight away, Lions on the back foot again, but claims on with Bahowski. Bahowski dumps it down and is eventually able to go for a change on the forecheck.
Carson is to skate, man.
Carson. Luca wants him to skate hard, but he doesn't. That's going to be coughed up towards Parson, but he's not quick enough to it again, and it clears the blue line, and there's going to be a chance for Preston. Now drops it back towards Gritans. Gritans fancy a bit of stick handling there. Gets the shot off in the end. He's brought down. No call. Shot was wide of Ballinger in the net. Behind the players. Players confused. It's in the corner. Far side. Trying and playing it through to Alex Preston. Blue line with Spraggan. Cutting in front of the net. Back behind the goal now. Griggles waits top of the face of the zone. Plays it low, save by Ballinger. Out towards Sam Miller. The youngster clears his zone. That's going to go all the way. And it takes deflection, so no icing. Stars aren't happy with it, but the Lions don't say it otherwise. Dan Martin. Dawling in the face off, so he doesn't put too much pressure on the floor. Check Fisher with it now. Rushby holds him up, and brilliant turnover there by the young 16-year-old for the Lions. Across the blue line, dumps. It's on net, saved by Brown. Now with Dan Martin at the hash marks for the Lions. Tries to play it through to the slot, but through traffic. And it tries to be run around by Luke Birchnell. It was coughed up behind the Stars net. And head in hands is Lucas Sheldon. Doesn't look too pleased.
No, we're having a lot of good opportunities, but just don't seem to be quite on the same page at the minute. Some good ideas coming, especially from the young kid Birch. You know, Birchnell, they're looking to reverse it around the net, maybe look for a play out front. Good stick lift here. Well, it just seems to be a step ahead of people. No one seems to be on the page that he wants them to be.
But Stars back in their own zone. Chances again for the Lions. Dumped all the way to the Lions zone towards Orton Shaw. Round the net, he plays it towards Owen Davis. Comes out towards the blue line, coughed up towards the Stars. Dowdle moving with a bit of speed. Behind, low shot, save, covered up there by... Oh, it's loose from Ballinger. Out towards the blue line, shot wide of the net, and Chris Sykes is going to have to get some... His legs moving there, but the 32-year-old doesn't have the speed, and he trickles all the way down in towards the Stars zone, but Ballinger got him out of a bit of trouble there. There's a shot coming across the crease.
Yeah, that's a good... Left to right save there. I had to figure out which side was left, which side was right, but good left to right save there from Isaac.
Out in front towards Elder. Elder, acres of speed to work with, shot wide of the net, however, right through the tram lines. Parson kind of being forced by picking in the middle with Sykes and Elder, and Walls out towards Elder again. Shot into the stick of Bahowski for the Lions. Turned over, they were able to clear of his own. Elder dumps it back towards Sykes, and former Elite League player tries playing it short side, saved by Ballinger. Sykes chases his own rebound. Now the Lions turn it over, and chance to work with Bahowski. Isn't quick to it, bats it away, forces Ward off it, and Parson can only just dump it and go for a change. You have to be quick with it though, as Sykes with, again, gains the blue line for the Stars. Got a wall of white to get through four of the Lions players, causing him issues. And Galloway nearly had a chance to go, but on the other end of the ice, with it in the Stars zone, comes out towards Tyler Summerton. He's on his own shot, save there by Brown in the Stars net. Making their best of a weak chance there is the Lions. Youngster coming across far side for the Stars on the counter-attack. Brown to the opposite side for in the middle. Shot saved by
Paddington. Great save. Great save.
The goal line there by Sam Miller. Brilliant stuff from point blank range to deal with that. Final 7 minutes here. We've been a long time without a whistle. And Gritans to Moss. Can't get to it. From round towards Miller. Loses it towards Gritans as Galloway goes for a change. That's going to be a blatant penalty there. Tripping up Sam Miller, the youngster. And Gritans just stares him down, apologises. That's as obvious as he's going to get. James Moss isn't happy. It goes to the ref on the other side to complain.
But Moss has got the penalty, not Gritans.
No, that was... Don't know what that could be about then, but it should be a blatant tripping call against Gritans. It was like a slew foot with his stick, just dragged it right through the calf of Sam Miller, knocking him off his feet behind the Lions goal on the boards.
Yeah, Moss was tied up in front of the net with Luke Thomas, so I'm not really sure what that could have been for. I didn't see the signal from the ref, but I'm sure we'll find out.
6:33 to play. Lions gone to a 2-minute power play. Score 4-0 here in favour of the Stars. Lions win the first face-off of their second power play of the game. Out towards Fisher. Right, back behind the goal to now the left-hand side. Grimshaw, tight angle shot just off the iron. Now back out towards Grimshaw in the corner. He's got Fisher with him and the hash marks. He drops it off to him. Out towards Summerton in the blue line. Cuts through to the middle. Shot! Nearly took a deflection. And Brown wasn't sighted to him. The Stars will clear. And it's a brilliant opening 50 seconds of a power play there from the Lions. Couple of chances. And there could be a chance for a consolation goal here. Moving through. In front of the Stars bench near side for Dan Martin. Gets his own, but all four Stars players behind the goal line aren't going to really make much of it. Run round towards Galloway.
Jump him.
Turning over there, though, for the Stars. Dan Martin quick to it. It's going to be cleared out. However, towards Summerton. Summerton heads up. Nearly coughs up towards Chris Sykes. And Chris Sykes heavy on the forecheck. Turning to his right there is Summerton with a bit of space sort of now.
It's a good recovery.
Side. Cuts in front of the Stars bench. Turns right in front of them. Leaves it into the middle, but it took an deflection. That goes all the way down. And messing around there in front of the bench. Summerton. Oh, he's been a punch to the head there. That's got to be called. Summerton. Chris Sykes just punched Tyler Summerton right into the head there.
Yeah, real big tough guy punching the guy with a cage on, eh?
Summerton now holding his stick as the Lions move to the blue line. Back in towards the zone with Tristan Grimshaw. Taking a tumble there is Bahowski. No calls for penalty. Summerton, final few seconds of the penalty. Shot coming in, nearly deflected to the net. Saved by Brown. So unlucky for the Lions there. And
just missed it.
That's going to be offside. Surely Luke Thomas has got to have a word with ref there.
That's crazy.
As he said, Susters was looking at it. And the 32-year-old has absolutely hammered the 17-year-old in the head in front of the Stars bench. Not good behaviour at all from the veteran on the Stars side. Former Elite League player. Former GB junior player. 21 games in the Elite League with the whole Stingrays back in the 2012-13 season. Expect better of him. But punching a 17-year-old, well, he up 4-0, there's no need for that at all. Shot coming in through traffic wide of the net.
I think he's a really good player, but you can't deny it, Sykes. I think he's, what, top point scorer in the league? I think something along the lines, or if not close enough. He's a really good player, but it's things like that that just slow you down. You don't need to see that. Bit of a tussle, he hit our guy, fair, you know, I think it was, from what I could see, it was a fair hit. And then he just skates right like that and just punches him in the side of the head. There's no need for it, really.
Yes.
But if Sussis is going to look at people and let him get away with these things, I guess you could argue why not.
Shot coming in from Hall on the top of the face-off, dot on the near side, saved comfortably by Ballinger. But back to Chris Sykes, he's definitely a player that strikes me along with Roland Gritans, but is obviously second, third, and big on points, and
there's
what's going on there?
He should have a stick under his chin.
As that's Alex Preston spearing Liam Orton Shaw right in front of the ref. Absolutely nothing called again. The linesman telling him to chill out. That is, again, disgraceful from the Stars bench.
Just
was going to go over for a word, but...
See, this is what we mean. He has to call something here, like...
He's going for the youngsters. It's getting out of it. It's getting out of hand, and they're going to have a word. Elder's going over. Captain Elder for the Stars going over for a word, but there surely has to be a penalty now. It shoved his stick right under the cage into the mouth.
Yeah, you can't... Yeah. You can't let that happen. Like, if the ref's gonna let him get away with that over and over again, what's it? He can't call a high stick there. That's a spear. He's just, there's no way around it. He just speared him in the chin. That's the only way you can really call it.
I think Preston might get called there, and he will do. Right, calm the game down. It's 4-0, 3:39 to play. There's no need for that from a Stars player.
No.
I'll eventually get back onto my point that I was making about Sykes and Grittans. The players that strike me for, they shouldn't have been in this division. They are extremely talented players, and it obviously Grittan's been everywhere around Europe, but obviously Sykes did play pro hockey for a short bit, played under 18s, under 20s for GB at the Worlds. It does make me wonder why he isn't. Penalty then for the Stars, and 2 minute power play for the Lions to get one back and shorten that gap before they go. But it does strike me, I think Sykes could definitely hold his own in NHL National. It does make me wonder why he isn't. He was with Billingham when it was the English National League. I think that was the second division then when the Stars moved to the third division when they moved into NIHL 1 and the whole change of the IHA. He stayed with them, but brilliant, talented player, but
great
play
pass.
For division one. That's a lovely stretch pass towards Birchall, gain the blue line, coming down by the near side, shot from a tight angle, takes a nick of the pads from Bram. Far side at the blue line with Fisher, drops it to the hash marks to Grimshaw. Comes out towards Summerton, top of the near side, face off dot, shot low, seen, but all the way is Brown. Summerton with it now towards, drops it towards Birchall, rimmed round. Dan Martin wins that out and taking a tumble, trying to flop a boarding call there. It's a curious one too. Try and sell his James Helens is actually Dan Martin missed for it and he just jumped headfirst into the boards. It was James Helens, but there's only a 2 minute call for a high stick instead of a spearing. That's going to come off the skate of Elder as Grimshaw tried there in a stretch pass to the far side and the Lions have to work to break out again. Out towards the red line at the boards. In towards the Star Zone. Wilkinson heavy touch and the Lions. Quick to it, but Wilkinson there to reward. 2 minutes left in the game then. Martin with it behind his goal. Bit asleep there as Wilkinson quick on a forecheck, nearly turning the puck over there for the Lions. Still behind his own net is Dan Martin. Now plays it across towards Bahowski, in towards the Lions zone on the near side in front of the bench is Mervran, but Parson coughing the puck up straight away. Through neutral ice we move. Line still with it, quick skating here. Shot coming in, save, collecting the rebound, and Robert Oxley, who's had an absolute great game so far, nearly gets the first goal for the Lions. It's come back the other way. It's Preston. Preston pushed hard by Oxley. Big kick clears the zone. That comes out towards Spraggan in the Stars zone. Final minute of play here in the first leg of this quarter final. Stars moving through the middle and towards the Lions zone. Swan time, a shot, save there!
Oh, it's just
been
snuck
given
in.
Actually, I thought it had been saved, but no, under the armpit it goes and the Stars make it five. It's the second in the game for Roland's Grittans. And with 57 seconds to go, Ballinger, I thought he had it there, but yeah, nicked under the armpit, but Stars make it five. And it's going to be a tall order tomorrow up in Billingham, but it's possible.
Yeah, it's definitely possible. I mean, obviously, that's going to be a bit of a heartbreak for the Lions. You know, they've done well all period. We've done well keeping them out and score. We've let one in with 57 seconds left. It's not amazing, but that makes sense. 5-0, anything can happen. We just need to show up tomorrow. We need to turn up, play hard. Hopefully,
try and make some good defensive plays here. Great, great save. Chance,
chance for a six there for the Stars, but it just chips over the net, deflected off the stick.
We need to make sure we don't get caught sleeping here.
Yeah, six might be a tall or might be impossible tomorrow. Five is doable. Oh, that's got to be called for a ball.
His hand was going.
Tyler Summerton's absolutely been hammered headfirst into the board. He tried to go for a wraparound. Then someone slashed at Ballinger, but...
That's crazy.
That should be called. Luke Thomas isn't happy on the Lions bench, but didn't see which Stars player it was, but...
That's insane.
That's poor there from Susters. The 17-year-old shoved headfirst. That'll be it. First 6 minutes in the quarterfinal. Is done. Second leg tomorrow up at the Billingham Forum, home of the Billingham Stars. But after 6 minutes of hockey, the first leg ends. Nottingham Lions 0, Billingham Stars 5. And looking at the prior results, 10-2, 5-2, 7-1, 8-2. You didn't get a goal, but second best result against this Stars team. But one, but of a number one seed here in this playoffs, won the regular season. What do you make of that 6 minutes, Luca?
I mean, like we've been saying all along, it was always going to be a sort of a difficult game for us. These guys are top, they won the league for a reason. They've got a lot of good talent within the team. We've got quite a young team and an experienced team, but like you said, second best result of the season, missing a few key players. I don't think you can be overly distraught with that. You know, the few bounces that we were going our way, if like what we said earlier in the period, two on one breakaways. Fish had one in front of the net that just bounced over his stick. That one that Brown got nearly just crossed the line. It's cleared by Odeem. And there's a few times there that could have easily been a 5-2, 5-3 game. Which goes into tomorrow, 2-0 deficit makes it look a lot better. But it's just the way it falls sometimes. And with Suster's call, making a few...
Shoddy calls.
Shoddy, yeah, that's the way you worded it better than I would have done. And maybe missing a few that he should have called. You know, that all sort of seems to suck the life out of the game there, but...
It's a bit unfortunate, because often I like to say that when refs miss calls, it's like they miss it on both sides, it's fairly even. But the only calls they really seem to miss were the nasty dirty ones, obviously, with the punch to the head. One of them got called, but for the wrong thing when the boarding. Like, in terms of, like, you've got your hooks, your trips, they were fairly good, but those just little dirty bits, they're letting too much slide, I think. But
yeah.
On to the post-game, we'll have the man of the match. Awards coming up. Both teams, who do you think and why?
Do you know, I hate to be biased and give my goalies some love, but you've got to look at Isaac's the man of the match. Look, 5 from 46. Yeah, I mean, that's a good... Against, like you said, great hands. He's got...
Not quite your 50-odd saves against, was it Hull or something? Where you came out of the Lions change rooms absolutely sweating just before Christmas, or it might have been against Blackburn. 56 shots. 8 goals, 1
in,
48 saves. Not quite that.
No, there's been too many games where it's happened along those lines. But yeah, but no, that's a good game from Isaac there. 41, he can't really be too upset. And like we said, there's a few that there's like that one that just squeaked in where they got the rebound. You tear that away, that's a 90%+ game there from him. So no complaints.
If
from the Stars, honestly, I have no idea.
Opinion what it's worth for the Lions. I think Robert Oxley is amazing. He's a defenseman, he's up there a lot, created a lot of I think he had the most chances to get a shot off or on a forecheck. He was so active up and down, really 200 meter game he played today from.
Yeah, I think maybe Luke Birchnell as well. He had an option.
Yeah, Birchnell had good. But for a defenseman, yeah, Robert Oxley was amazing. I think Callum Wilson had a good game. Elder got a goal, Roland's Britann's couple of goals. We'll get it now. Joseph Walls gets it then. Part of an under the radar for us. Fourth season with the Stars, the 20-year-old started playing in the NHL 1-16. He's unlike a lot of the Lions team, he gets another match award. And that gets a roar from a small contingent of the Stars fans that have travelled down towards Nottingham. Sam Miller gets it. I think so. He's only had a handful of games. He's come up from Lions to the youngster again. Promising youngster. I believe he's been on a few of the GB under 16 squads. one of the most sought after youngsters, I think. I think he was on the Youth Olympic squad for Great Britain as well. Big game for him. Well deserved, and he's definitely got a promising future. He's one that went under the radar for us in the second period when we were talking to Zach about the future.
Yeah, definitely. Love you too, Luke.
Luke Thomas's final home game, probably. Well, it will be, because the playoffs will be in.
Yeah, some would say long overdue, but he'll be sorely missed still. You know, he's been, like we said.
The 38-year-old just had his first child. Congratulations to you. He can enjoy his retirement. He's got one more game to play, unless a miracle happens tomorrow.
Yeah, true.
But Luke Thomas, final home game here. That'll be all from the Noscombe Lions YouTube channel.
Love you.
That'll be it from us, as we get a little shout from Josh Heyman as well.
Yeah, good game from everyone. We'll just see how it goes tomorrow, eh?
That'll be it from the season here on the Nottingham Lions YouTube channel. Thank you everyone for following us passionately, or you've been watching the streams, coming in person, cheering the fans on. It's been an absolutely amazing season here. I've loved every bit of it since joining mid-season. I know you had to kind of go away and take on responsibilities full-time with the Panthers, but I'm sure you've been loving it. I'm sure you'd rather be with them than us. Thank you to everyone. It's been an absolutely amazing season. Thank you to Chris Gadsby and Laura Turner for letting me do this ever so amazing job. We'll be back next season. We'll see you in September for the 2024-25 season. But from us here at the Nottingham Lions, thank you all to the fans, and we'll see you in the autumn.
See you in a bit. Bye-bye.